Police have confirmed they have detained former Kampala Capital City Authority KCC Executive Director Dorothy Chisaka, a former Deputy David Luimbazi, and former Director of Public Health and Environment Dr. Daniel Okello. According to police spokesperson Chituma Rusoke, the trio have been detained and are awaiting arraignment before the courts of law. Earlier today, the sacked KCC top officials were interrogated at the Criminal Investigations Directorate CID headquarters in Tivoli, Kampala, following summons issued last week concerning the collapse of the Chitezi garbage landfill. Former KCC Executive Director Dorothy Chisaka, her Deputy Engineer David Luimbazi, and Dr. Daniel Okello, the former Public Health Director, arrived at the CID offices at 8:30 a.m. well ahead of their scheduled 10 a.m. appearance. Nakawa West MP Joel Senyonyi has claimed he is the target of a bill that seeks to change the way the Leader of Opposition in Parliament, LOP, and the Shadow Cabinet members are selected. Senyonyi, who is also the current LOP, claimed today while appearing before the Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee, which is scrutinizing the proposed law. The bill, which is titled the Administration of Parliament Amendment Bill 2024, was introduced by Richard Lumuu, the Mitiana South MP, on the opposition Democratic Party DP ticket. Senyonyi also contended that the election of the leaders on the opposition side of parliament by members would make the opposition prone to fragmentation, and that a fragmented opposition is less effective in presenting a united front.
When opposition members in parliament are forced to compete for leadership positions, it can lead to divisions and weaken their collective ability to unite and hold the ruling government accountable.
The bill seeks to amend the Administration of Parliament Act, CAP 272, to alter the selection process of the LOP by allowing all members of the opposition in parliament to participate in the process.
The mover of this bill says the bill is intended for the good of the opposition. But as I have been observing, all opposition political parties have disregarded this proposed amendment, saying it is not in any way relevant. So I ask, which opposition is the mover of the bill talking about?
Currently, Section 8 of the Administration of Parliament Act, CAP 272, provides for the election of Leader of Opposition by the party in opposition to the government having the greatest numerical strength in Parliament. The Uganda Cranes have landed safely back in Uganda following their 2-1 victory over South Sudan in Juba, a win that brings them closer to qualification for the 2025 Africa Cup of Nations AFCON. Despite a heavy downpour that ascended to Juba both before and during the game, Uganda showed characters to secure all 3 points. Ugandans in South Sudan turned up in big numbers and indeed made their presence felt amidst the harsh weather conditions. Coach Paul Put made 3 changes from the team that had started at Mandela National Stadium last week. At the start of the second half, Coach Put made change, introducing Mutyaba in place of Okello. The change paid off with Mutyaba's delivery from a free kick in the 65th minute, aided by Seymour Gabi before deflecting off South Sudan's Alfred Leku into the back of the net. The Uganda Cranes held on to the lead throughout the remaining minutes to eventually claim victory.
To Sudan was not bad, everything was good, and all the players reached well, and everyone was in a good mood, the way you see on the pitch. So that's how we got the results, because everyone was in a good condition.
The result means Uganda leads Group K by 10 points and needs just a point from the remaining 2 games. The next window in November will see Uganda hosting South Africa on the 15th of November before ending the campaign away to Congo.
Well, for us, it is not just about qualifications, it's about developing a team that will represent our country with our vision of becoming number one football nation in Africa on and off the pitch.